Let's talk about another really valuable tool we have at our disposal here, and that's going to allow us to find our way around different parts of the timeline, the places that we're going to want to get back to, and that's using markers.
So every time you hit the M key, and let's bring the keyboard up here, wherever the cursor position happens to be, you're going to get a marker. It comes up a little orange box here, and it extends down in the timeline. If you move the cursor away, you can see that orange line. Also notice that when a marker is created, it creates a field to enter a name in, which you can just type anything in there, and then hit enter. Or you could ignore putting the name in and just move on to the next thing you want to do. But also notice that as I put a marker in here, they're being numbered 1, 2, 3. And even though you can put as many markers as you want in your project, it's only going to number them from 1 to 99. But one of the nice things about the markers is we can jump the cursor directly from marker point to marker point by hitting the numeric keys on top of the letters here. And so if I hit 1, it's going to make that marker jump to 1. If I hit 3, it's going to jump right to 3.
And also you can move the cursor around between markers using your keyboard by going to Control and the left and right arrows. That'll step you through consecutive markers, so Control left arrow or Control right arrow. Also, if you had lots and lots of markers and you wanted to get rid of them real quick, you can open Edit Details, which we'll talk about a little later. But just real quickly, I'm going to go to View, Edit Details, set it to Show Markers. And now in the upper left, click that so it selects all. And now I hit the delete key. And all the markers are gone. So again, let's undo. So as you're organizing your project, you might use markers to denote different sections of the project, and you'll be able to jump directly to each section as you need.
Or you can just use these markers to name things that are happening in your project, like this rider is passing that bottled water on the ground there, and I don't know why I'd want to keep track of this, but anyway, if you didn't name it while the marker is being created, you can right-click that marker and hit rename, and now we call it water bottle. So if you're looking for where that water bottle was, you can find it, just because basically you've left a note in the project here. I'm going to place a few more markers. And if you need to adjust the position of the markers, you can just click and drag them and they'll move around for you. And if you want to move several together, you can select and deselect these just the same way you can select or deselect events. Let's say I have the number 2 highlighted here because I've clicked on it. I'm going to shift and then click number 5, and now everything in between, as well as the 2 and 5, are now selected. You can see that instead of the solid orange box, we have the clear part in the middle where the number is. And now if I click and drag one of them, all those selected ones will drag. You can also hold the Control key and do the same type of selection as usual. So let's say I have 2, 4, and 6 now selected, and I can just drag those. And then it also goes for deleting as well. So 2, 4, and 6 are selected, and what you do is right-click on one of them and choose Delete, and then all the selected ones are now deleted.